Bills, Ravens on EA Sports from M&T Bank Stadium. And we welcome you live with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gaudin. And Charles, you and I were down on the field before the game, patrolling the sidelines, and we both said, gosh, both teams seem so confident. But obviously, one has to come out on top.
Yeah, and they're amped up. They're honed to a fine edge. You can tell the preparation has been intense for this game. Now, who's going to make the breakthrough, though? Who's going to seize the advantage? Let's go ahead and kick this thing off and find out.
Kicks it in the air. We're underway. Could have gone for the touchback. Instead, here comes the return. And he's brought down right around the 23. That's where the return ends. So here are the Bills under head coach Rex Ryan as they get set for their first opportunity. They're led out by their mobile quarterback, the six-year man. It's Tyrod Taylor.
I've always loved Tyrod Taylor's mobility. I love his footwork, his ability to escape. But his underrated arm, accurate downfield throwing, that's what I really like about his game.
And a run here with McCoy. Left side run. And the tackle there by Eric Weddle. And here's our first look today at this offense.
And let's start with LeSean Shady McCoy, their star running back. He can do everything. Run it inside, get to the perimeter, and of course, catch it out of the backfield.
And the starting lineups brought to you by Gatorade. Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Here we go. One, nine.
The give to McCoy. And he is tackled. Hardly anything there.
Many doubted Eric Weddle coming out of college, but they don't anymore. One of the best, most versatile safeties in the league.
Third and one.
Here we go.
Catches the snap out of the gun. Throws to his right. Gets the first down. Partner, nothing complicated here. This is just a pretty simple drag route.
You're exactly right, Brandon. Instead of throwing it downfield, they just throw it underneath and let the receiver do the work.
And on first down.
Come on, let's go!
And a run here with McCoy. And this play will lose yards.
It's not something you see on every play, but when a runner gets the opportunity to fire a stiff arm, meaning taking his hand and putting it out on a defender and then extending it to create space between him and the defender in order to gain additional yardage, it's an excellent play when used correctly.
Second and 11.
Here we go. Grand 38. Grand 38.
The give to McCoy. And a really nice game.
Really nice setup by the runner. Actually got the defender off balance, and then he fires out a stiff arm to allow him to pick up additional yardage.
Third and two.
Here we go.
On the tackle, it's Ladarius Webb.
And typically, the defenders are the ones that dish out the punishment. On this one, we see the runner do exactly that with a perfectly legal, well-executed stiff arm. Oh, yes, it's still in the game.
And this time he will signal for the fair catch. So here come the Ravens now, ready to get the football for the first time. They'll be led out by their veteran quarterback, a former Blue Hen out of Delaware. It's Joe Flacco.
And you can say so many positive things about him as a player. Durable, guy's got a big right arm. Receivers absolutely love him to be able to go downfield and grab the football. But I think he elevates his play. In fact, I know he elevates his play when he gets to the postseason. And that's the kind of guy you want leading your team.
And he's hit right away. In this offense, they look towards Steve Smith a lot.
It's a good idea, because if you don't, you're going to hear about it. No one plays the wide receiver position angrier or better than Steve Smith Sr.
Second down, 9 yards to go. And they'll run it with Forsett over to the right side. Tackle made by Hughes.
Ronald Darby's selection makes a general manager look good. A terrific ball hawk who is eager to tackle in the run game.
And now it's a third and four situation for the offense. Ball is thrown incomplete. Great job by the defense. So the pass incomplete there, nothing doing against the man coverage.
Excellent coverage downfield. Most times the receiver wins. In this case, the defensive back did.
And it looks like he'll be spotted down right at midfield at the 50. The offense will operate from the pistol. The stop by Weddle.
It's not something you see on every play. But when a runner gets the opportunity to fire a stiff arm, meaning taking his hand and putting it out on a defender and then extending it to create space between him and the defender in order to gain additional yardage, it's an excellent play when used correctly.
Second down and 13.
Here we go.
Shotgun formation. And he's able to haul it in.
As a defender, you're never crazy about a completion, but anything that doesn't result in a first down, you're going to be happy about. The key is to make sure it stays that way all game long. No missed tackles that turn into big plays.
And the offense needs 7 out of this play on third down. Takes a snap out of the gun. Throws left side. It'll be a gain of 15. And the offensive coordinators on both sides, they need to go back to the drawing board. Good thing is, it's a good game. We're even, just haven't had a lot of points. Quarter two is on the way, but first, this timeout. And on first down.
Let's go. One, nine.
And a run here with McCoy. Gets some yards. Not a whole lot there.
Really nice setup by the runner. Actually got the defender off balance. And then he fires out a stiff arm to allow him to pick up additional yardage.
Thank you.
And they'll set up out of the pistol. They'll go on the ground and give the tackle to Suggs.
And typically the defenders are the ones that dish out the punishment. On this one, we see the runner do exactly that with a perfectly legal, well-executed stiff arm. Oh yes, it's still in the game.
Third and nine.
Come on, let's go.
The snap from the gun. This time over the middle. And there's the tackle, but there's also a first down for the offense.
Brent, as we know, the only score that counts is the one up on the board, which team is winning. But between receivers and defensive backs, receivers and any defender, they keep a private scoreboard. How many times did you break a tackle, and how many times did they tackle you cleanly?
A pistol look this time. The give to McCoy. Up the middle. Terrell Suggs bringing him down that time.
Yes, this is where the expression staying ahead of the chains comes into play. Good runs like that one set you up well for third down.
So the offense now dealing with a second and seven. He'll operate from the gun. Throws right side, and he hauls it in. And he crosses the first down marker before he stopped.
That was not a completion that results in a highlight video. But at the same time, if you have those kind of completions all game long, eventually one of them might turn into a highlight.
So now it's first and goal.
Let's go.
Little motion now from the tight end. They'll try the ground game. And the tackle there by Eric Weddle.
It's not something you see on every play, but when a runner gets the opportunity to fire a stiff arm, meaning taking his hand and putting it out on a defender and then extending it to create space between him and the defender in order to gain additional yardage, it's an excellent play when used correctly.
Let's go! Ohio! Ohio!
Try to get the edge on the toss play. Touchdown, Buffalo!
Great field position has to be one of the best friends an offense can have. When you don't have very far to go, you should cash it in with points.
So they're in for six. Let's see if they can make it seven. The PAT is up, and the PAT is good. Everyone getting lined up, and it looks like we are just about set to rock. Hold up here, laundry down. Let's see what the penalty's for. And a huge chunk of yardage.
Personal foul. Clipping. Receiving team. First down.
Getting set on first down. The handoff to the back. Moving left side. Able to dance around for some yards.
As this game continues, the offensive line has to do a better job of creating space for the running back.
And with that, it's two-minute warning time here, the NFL on EA Sports. So it's second and eight.
Ready! Ready! Hut!
Hut! Shotgun formation. And that ball probably should have been picked off, but instead incomplete.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
Let's see if the defense tries any pressure here on third and eight. Middle of the field throw, and the connection not made, incomplete pass.
Whether they deserve credit or not, the defense is going to take credit for that incompletion because it always feels good when you slow down an offense.
The defense holds serve there on the incompletion, and now the special teams unit out for the punt. So he'll try and return the punt. This time Lewis gets the stop. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. And an underneath throw this time. So he's finally brought down, but not before a really good game.
People like to see sacks and big hits in the open field, but sometimes the bend and don't break philosophy works awfully well for a defense. They still have to find a way to score points. And as long as you're not giving those up, you're doing just fine.
Second and three. Shotgun snap. Tries the deep ball, and it's thrown incomplete. And 3 full yards here for the offense to get on third down. They'll operate from the gun. Pass is short, left it short, it's incomplete.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
And the ball sails through the uprights for 3 points.
Nothing but confidence there. Just strolled out there and knocked it through the post. An easy 3.
In the kickoff team, they all appear set. And this return will go right around the 30. So a nickel formation here for the defense. The snap from the gun. And it is complete. He caught it. So a nice chunk of yardage there before he's taken down to the ground.
And that's the kind of pass that adds up over time, Brandon. You may not have picked up a first down there, but if you keep chipping away at it, eventually big plays may result.
So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. And some options here for the offense on second and two. He fires it, and it's complete.
That one was whistled in there. If you're a receiver, you have to get your hands on it so it doesn't get to your body, because that one is going to hurt.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. It's a screen. Caught. And the stop comes right around the 35 this time. And the offensive side, they're going to stop the game with a timeout. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout.
Brandon, he really fired that one in there. Excellent arm strength, and if I'm the receiver, I'm shaking my hands after that one.
Second down, 7. From the gun. Flacco launches it. And that one almost taken away by the defense, but it falls innocently to the ground.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
Seven yards remain now on third down. To the air attack. And it is caught. And he's wrangled down by Gilmore. And now they're in the hurry up from the shotgun. Touchdown, Ravens.
Had to be excited when they saw the field position they were given, and they ran out there and executed perfectly to score.
And now the point after. And he splits the uprights for the PAT. And everyone is lined up for the kickoff. Tackle made across the 25 at the 27. And on first down.
Here we go.
And a run here with McCoy. And picks up some nice yardage. And with two quarters down now in the books, a break for us, a break for you as well. We'll talk to you in quarter number three after this timeout. It's the NFL on EA Sports. And the kicker is set. We're just about ready. And time to see how these two sides come out of the locker room as we get set for the third. Here we go. And he'll get it to the 28-yard line before he's brought down on the return. And on first down. The carry here by Forsett. And he stopped.
Brandon, it appears that this offense is just trying to get into a groove by establishing their running game. Small gains as they try to accumulate the yardage that they hope will pay off throughout the game.
Second down, they need less than a yard to pick up the first. And they'll run it with Forsett. So the tackle is made, but he's beyond the first down marker. And that carry will earn them the first down.
A little bit of leverage there. The low man won at the point of attack with the offensive lineman creating space for the runner.
So first and 10. A carry here by Forsett. Able to pick up some good yardage.
And many use the running game like boxers do. Body blow after body blow after body blow. You may not get what you want early, but those add up, and by the fourth quarter, you could break a big one.
Seven yards to go on second down. Unable to hit his man there, and it falls to the ground.
Whether they deserve credit or not, the defense is going to take credit for that incompletion because it always feels good when you slow down an offense.
Third and seven. Snap comes back out of the shotgun formation. Slings to the sideline, and he brings it in for the catch.
It's not the most glamorous route that a receiver can run, but how crisply did he run the out route in order to make that play successful?
And on first down. And they'll run it with Forsett. Coverage there in a hurry, and down he goes immediately.
Really nice setup by the runner. Actually got the defender off balance, and then he fires out a stiff arm to allow him to pick up additional yardage.
Second and eight.
Move 45. Move 45.
Shotgun snap here. Flacco looking way downfield. Nearly picked off, but he dropped it.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
And if they want to keep this drive alive, they'll need 8 yards here on third down. Tries the left side. Brings it in. Powers over the defender. And a good chunk of yardage is gained on the play.
I don't know what you thought, partner, but I thought he was gone after that catch. I thought he was taking that one to the house. How about the defense, though? Never gave up on the play and eventually ran him down.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. A carry here by Forsett, running right side. Taken to the ground, but not before a good pickup for the offense.
And typically the defenders are the ones that dish out the punishment. On this one, we see the runner do exactly that with a perfectly legal, well-executed stiff arm. Oh yes, it's still in the game.
6 yards to go here on second down.
Move 45. Move 45.
And they'll run it with Forsett, taking the ball and moving to the left. And it's 6 points for the Baltimore Ravens.
Similar to baseball, where you walk the leadoff hitter and you don't expect him to come around and score, almost impossible. Anytime the defense has to defend a short field, you usually end up seeing the result we saw, giving up points.
And now they'll try to add the PAT. And the extra point try is converted. And we are teed up and ready to go. And he's going to run it out here. Penalty marker is down here. And a huge chunk of yardage.
Personal foul, clipping, receiving team. First down.
And on first and 10 now. The give to McCoy. And a good chunk of yardage there.
is not something you see on every play, but when a runner gets the opportunity to fire a stiff arm, meaning taking his hand and putting it out on a defender and then extending it to create space between him and the defender in order to gain additional yardage, it's an excellent play when used correctly.
The offense will operate from the pistol. And a run here with McCoy. And he's wrangled down, but not before picking up the first. Offensive line gets good push, and they pick up the first down.
And the defenders couldn't hold the point of attack, and that created the space needed for the offense to pick up the first down.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Tosses left side, and it's complete.
As a defender, you're never crazy about a completion, but anything that doesn't result in a first down, you're going to be happy about. The key is to make sure it stays that way all game long. No missed tackles that turn into big plays.
Second down, 4.
Here we go. One, nine.
Catches the snap out of the gun. Slings it left side. The stop by Weddle. So an excellent throw and an excellent catch there.
Zone coverage, which means you just have to find the open areas in between defenders, is exactly what happened on that play.
Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. 75% of the way home in regulation. Three quarters down, one to go, and we'll get to that last one after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back here as we are about to resume play here in the next quarter. Getting set on first down. Shotgun formation. Deep shot here by Taylor. Oh, a huge catch. And it's a Bills touchdown.
The catch and the touchdown, they were the end result of a terrific route run by the receiver.
And a try at the extra point here. And he adds the point after. Everyone getting lined up, and it looks like we are just about set to rock. He's going to try and return this one. And on the return, he's able to get it to the 27-yard line there. The defense here in a dime look. Takes a snap out of the gun. Tries it over the middle. And a nice grab there for the reception.
For all you young defenders out there, when you're in zone defense, you have to know where your holes are and find a way to adjust when the offense tries to attack them.
And the defense coming out this time in the nickel. The snap from the gun. Throws the deep ball. And that ball probably should have been picked off, but instead incomplete.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
Second and 10. Zips it, and it's complete. And he brings him down at the 40.
Defense is going to every game talking about winning the early downs to make third down a difficult assignment for an offense. On that play, the defense accomplished its goal.
Third and nine. They'll operate from the gun. Trying to complete it on the sideline. There were a couple holes there, partner. Was that zone coverage?
That's exactly what it was, Brandon. When you see man-to-man, that defender runs with the receiver. In this case, they were just taking care of their zone coverages, their responsibilities on the field, and the offense found the open space.
And the return man getting set, the punter getting set after they hit the pass, but a little short of the first down marker. And able to pick up some good yardage. And they'll set up out of the pistol. The handoff. In search of running room on the left. Down he goes.
That's a fine job by the defense, limiting the offense and putting them in a tougher situation.
Second down and nine. The give to McCoy. Moving to the left side. On the tackle, it's Ladarius Webb.
The counterplay is not for everyone, but certain runners love it. They have great vision and love to feel everyone moving in one direction, put their foot in the ground, and cut back the other way.
So just 1 yard to go here on third down. And it's a handoff, moving right side. And now they get into enemy territory across the 50. And LeSean McCoy showing that at times he can still be the real McCoy.
And I love how he runs because he breaks off some of the prettiest runs you will see. Starting wide, cutting back inside, excellent vision. The man they call Shady still has it.
Time is starting to run out, really becoming a factor. We'll see if the defense can get the stop they need to get the ball back to the offense. And a run here with McCoy. And a carry here to the right side. He's got some yards.
Really nice setup by the runner. Actually got the defender off balance, and then he fires out a stiff arm to allow him to pick up additional yardage.
And with that, we arrive at the two-minute warning. A pistol look this time. The give to McCoy. And give the tackle to Suggs. And they're going to take a timeout here to stop the clock. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. It's third down, 6 yards to go for the offense. Short pass, and he's able to haul it in. And that will stop the clock. A timeout is taken. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. And that's one where you wonder, does the quarterback even bother throwing that ball?
It's a great question, Brandon, because there were no open receivers, and the only one they could possibly get it to was behind the line of scrimmage.
And he's all alone in the backfield. Shotgun formation. And he's able to bring it in. And it's a fumble.
Before every game, the receivers envision themselves making big plays, catches, long runs. Well, it just happened there. But sometimes when you look at the big board and you slow your feet down, keep running. That's why it was caught.
So the offense has it first and 10. And a run here with McCoy. And the tackle there by Eric Weddle. A timeout here to try to preserve the time. That's why they take the TO. All right, so the timeout over and all 11 men back out onto the field for the defense.
And typically the defenders are the ones that dish out the punishment. On this one, we see the runner do exactly that with a perfectly legal, well-executed stiff arm. Oh, yes, it's still in the game.
And they're behind the sticks here a bit now, dealing with a second and 12. They'll try the handoff. And a really nice game.
The offense is in total control right now. And while they don't want to be in anything close to a hurry up, they want to make sure they do things with discipline now. Get to the line of scrimmage, line up correctly, take time off the clock, snap the ball late in the play clock, and run the game out.
Third and eight.
Let's go. Grand 38. Grand 38.
Cut. Shotgun snap. Goes right side. And it's caught. And now it is fourth down after that stop.
That was not a completion that results in a highlight video. But at the same time, if you have those kind of completions all game long, eventually one of them might turn into a highlight.
They were able to get the pass completion, but could not pick up the first, and they will punt it. A gain of 12. And when we head out to the game, Charles, we hope for these battles, a fantastic one here that we witnessed.
If you had no rooting interest in the game, it was a terrific game. Both teams played well. Unfortunately, only one could win.
I'm Brandon Gauden. Certainly have to thank Charles Davis, my broadcast partner, and our entire crew. We'll catch you next time right here. It's the NFL on EA Sports.